The therapeutic panorama and the diagnostic of acute myeloid leukemia has greatly changed in last years. We are going from a nightmare to the road to the cure of acute myeloid leukemia thanks to new targets discovery and new target therapies. However, some patients don't respond or became refractory to the drugs that we commonly used, and understanding the environment mediated the drug resistance is a great effort, and I think a new frontier that we have to better understand. And in particular, we have to understand the E-selectin, which could be a potential new target, E-selectin ligand, and in particular there is an agent, uproleselan, which can go to as a potential new target therapy for patients who express these ligands. We have seen data recently published on blood, phase 1-2 for relapsed refractory patients in combination with the MEC in conventional chemotherapy, and in particular we have to underline data for patients who are high expressors of this biomarker, which could be a potential new evaluation which we should perform in our relapsed refractory setting. This was the basis. Also, the great tolerability and in particular the low rate of mucositis was the basis to combine uproleselan in an ongoing frontline clinical trial in which uproleselan is added to 3+7, also in consolidation and then as a bridge to allogeneic stem cell transplantation. I think that this is a really interesting drug and we should better discover not only the data of clinical trials, but I hope to have at least a relapsed refractory setting this drug as soon as possible available also in our countries. We participated to the clinical trials and had a really good experience in this drug.